connected.
The turn point was actually at about 46. We were lucky we could get that thing at whatever, 29 or whatever it was.
User joined your channel.
Good morning. Good afternoon.
Hi, Tim.
Hi, Tim.
Server's up.
Good day, everyone.
Yeah, my pass was 28 yesterday. Hi, Josh. Nice picture, Josh, yesterday from my plane.
Yeah, that was pretty cool, huh?
Cool, yeah.
Cloud flying along.
Maybe some wave.
So if parts of the finish are above the finish, the center of the finish height, is the PDA going to be quoting us the upper or the, I wonder what the PDA is using. We ran into this once.
Yeah, isn't the PDA measuring from the base of the finish pole?
We had something once where it didn't use the center of the finish, the pole.
Okay.
I thought.
I'm not sure, to be honest.
What is the minimum finish altitude?
It's nothing.
Okay.
He's zero, Tim, yeah.
Now the field elevation is 250.
Yeah, the ring is 300 and the finish point is 250.
Oh, I forgot the ballast.
I'm sorry?
I forgot ballast. After
that. Oh, you bet. I don't know if you can get in and out or not.
You're talking about turn point one, yeah.
You know, we've been talking about I was talking about the finish.
Oh, okay. Maybe I didn't understand the question.
Yeah, it's a funny thing.
User entered your channel.
So that means, guys, so we can finish with the DDH in negative today, like the other day, or? About the height elevation of the finish, because it's zero, but the height is 250, 250.
Yeah, zero is okay. Hi, John.
Hi, John. Today is for the duo, I think, right? The duo discus.
Yeah, me too.
Don't forget two pilots.
No. Yes, yes, makes sense.
What did you do, Richard? Did you get in and out?
Yeah.
You made it, then.
Yep.
Good. Good.
Now I'm right at the back of the
field. Well, I'll be behind you.
As it goes behind me. I'm behind NOI.
Yeah, I'm behind NOI. I'm five behind you.
Okay. F1 is in front of me. And Bruce is in front of F1.
No, that's not me. That's that's L16. That's L16. I'm Life is Good. L-I-G.
You're right.
I hope that guy behaves, you know, people think I'm him.
I'm going on the paint job.
I have the Poland one. It has a red tail.
Okay.
There's an eagle on it with the rope and stuff.
Oh, okay. You're up in the air now.
Yeah.
I see.
How was your 13-hour day, Tim?
Well, it was long.
How often do you have to do that?
Only four times a year.
Yeah, I had shift work and only 12 and a half hours per day.
Yeah.
But also leisure time between. No, I didn't saw this guy before. Bravo 7-3.
Yeah, he looks new. Hey, John Mattel, did I see you were flying the Montana series?
I have flown it, yes.
How was that?
It's actually pretty good. The guys that are organizing it are well done, and there's some good people coming in there. I just try and hang on. Yeah. It's relatively new, so you know the whole jury's still out. But the prospects look good. And then a U.S. soaring on Tuesday and Thursday, with it on Wednesday, the Montana. That gives 3 days of good choices.
Oh, I thought Montana was Thursday. Okay, good. That's good to know. I signed up for it.
Yeah, Montana's on Wednesday and U.S. soaring Tuesday and Thursday. Thursday being an hour later than Tuesday.
Yeah, I remember. It was an all-star cast in the U.S. race yet last night, I noticed.
Yeah, I had trouble with that one. I couldn't get in. Couldn't get in a groove with it, I guess.
There were some really good flyers there. So you live way out in the boonies, Josh?
Kind of, yeah.
I mean, is there like nobody around for miles?
Well, I have a neighbor. It's maybe half a mile.
Yeah.
Most of the land around me, no one lives on.
And mine's like 40 feet, so.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I can see the glow from the city at night, you know.
Yeah.
When it's cloudy and whatnot.
Where is that, Josh?
In New Mexico by Moriarty, Santa Fe.
Oh, okay.
Really quiet at night, I bet.
Yeah, it's very quiet. It's quiet all day, too, unless an airplane or helicopter goes over.
We really enjoy Taos and Santa Fe. We go there end of October or beginning October when the art the art open studios are open on the mountains between Taos and Santa Fe. We stay in Taos. We stay in Taos, and then we, you know, take the road to Santa Fe. A lot of good photography, a lot of good old Spanish missions to see and take photos of. And really nice out there.
Yeah. That's cool.
Pardon me?
I said that's cool, Bruce.
Yeah, it's really a nice place.
Yeah.
I've actually found pottery shards on my property.
Shards, dang it. They're technically called shards, not shards.
I would have called it shards.
the correct archaeological term for broken bits of pottery are sherds, not shards. Don't ask me why.
Interesting. So you might have a valuable archaeological site there, dude.
Well, I mean,
yeah, most people don't want to live out here. It's pretty difficult to get out here.
How far is the gas station? That's one good measurement of how far in the middle of where you are.
Like 40 minutes.
Okay, yes, so you're quite with the point, yeah. What do you use for internet?
My cell phone. There's a cell phone tower I can see. It's about 5 miles, I guess, on the interstate. I can see the interstate about 5 miles out.
That's cool. You actually use your cell phone, or is it just a cell connection? Because you probably get, I know they have actually
cell phones.
You might look into getting like actual proper cellular modem. That might work more reliable than using the cell phone.
That's what I mean.
As opposed to are you like using the Wi-Fi hotspot or something?
Yeah, that's exactly it.
Yeah, you might look into getting something like that. You probably have to put, I don't know how, price-wise, how any of that works, but that might be a better option. So then you can hook up to your router and basically it just works like a modem, it hooked up to the ISP, so it'd be a little bit more reliable than the hotspot and cell phone, and probably a little more convenient.
Yeah, I've often wondered, should I get rid of my sort of Wi-Fi connection, because this basically it's a cell phone on the wall, isn't it? So I was thinking the opposite way, but as you say, it works very reliably.
I'm surprised you don't have cable or fiber, Richard.
Well, I did, but unfortunately, it got damaged. And I can't afford paying to get somebody to dig it up. It was cheaper actually, just to get the telephone company to install a sort of modem.
Well, like Verizon has a wireless internet and stuff now. I mean, different phone companies have that now. They just play like a router that has a cell phone modem basically built into it. And
it's a low start today. Starting from 430.
Yeah, the cloud base here is 17, and cloud volume is 12.
User disconnected from your channel.
I found some busted arrowheads too, spear tips. That's pretty neat.
Wow. Very cool.
User joined your channel.
Might have to gear out.
Hello.
Esquizo.
Hello. Fine.
Ciao Esquizo, come stai?
Tutto bene.
Guten Abend.
Guten Abend. So I'm starting to play a little bit more on Condor, eh, Tim? Did you realize?
Yeah, that's nice. So the real season in Italy has ended?
Let's say that now it's the paraglider season.
Yeah.
Right here. Okay.
Get some here. I don't think paragliders in winter would be kind of cold.
Yeah, they are. But I have a cold harness, so there's no problem. We have a magic place nearby Rome. It's called Norma, and yeah, it's quite good all year. I mean, per year ago, so I got some plus fives at January. Incredible.
One thing I really like about these riders is good visibility. Well, it's just with the pilot in the front seat, you get so much better visibility up. Like if you look backwards, you know, on the arc is the headrest cam, but he's leaning over a little bit because he goes well in all directions.
we have some smoke generators.
User joined your channel.
Hi all. Looks like I finally connected.
Yeah, it's probably the TMS thing. Yeah, you can get like that. That's part of your ISP acting, right?
Thank you, good. Good luck.
Are you scared? Good luck, everyone.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Okay, good luck, Tim.
Good luck to you.
Thanks.
Thank you, Maxim.
Peppers.
Good luck, Bruce.
And in fact, good luck, everybody. Good luck, everyone.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Good luck, Spiso.
Seems me yet I got
that. I should do more. I should do the gun test again. I mean, I don't want them all the time, but you know, once in a while, they're fun.
Yeah, but you know, this is a window, but they all started the same, so it seems really to be an Elgata. Just maybe there was a low start.
Yeah, low start, yeah, everybody was already at the start of the TV, yeah. Well, that's interesting. Everybody's going that way. Like, you're going wrong.
I'm going to go north. The same way as I was thinking, right? So I don't know why we're going that way. We must be doing something like It's always fun to do something wrong.
Yeah, I'm going wrong. I asked this John and I decided no ball was John anymore.
I think it's like
XR. You know the flight, John, in the north? Hmm? It was Richard, our last flight in the north. Our guys are going south. I think it was to Calamsee or Niederalpenraum. That was a joke.
What? Yesterday, I think it was XRR following.
Oh, not yesterday. Two days ago.
Well, I don't know. I was saying yesterday, though. I ended up just like going, okay, never mind, never going to finish this. And then someone followed me as I was just off flying around.
I hope he's not following me thinking I know where I'm going, because I'm not going anywhere.
It could be just a fun task this year.
Yeah, it was. My map disappeared again. Why does it do that?
Is it whatever you're using to pin them on the VR, maybe?
Say again?
Is it whatever program you use to pin them in the VR so you can see them? Is that what's happening,
yeah,
or is
yeah,
it?
Yeah. I mean, I've still got TeamSpeak and Tessa in VR. But the map from the map has disappeared.
I wonder if we'll do it if you were just use it in 2D as well. I wonder if it's the program crashing or it's weird.
Isn't that normal?
Mm-hmm. Left, John.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Hey, good luck, John.
I appreciate it.
Just following the herd, I was kind of shocked to see how far south I am all of a sudden.
Yeah, it was a gradual turn to the south at first, but now it's gotten pretty well, we've gone a ways, but gotten pretty much more southerly.
Yeah, I was thinking I was going to take the blue line.
Well, it's about to turn back to the northeast just a little.
I'm just out Sunday cruising here.
Yeah, but it's not Monday yet.
Oh, you came over here too? I thought you went north. Cool.
Yeah, that was my first weekend, yeah. But all guys, most guys are going here, yeah. I decided to go with them.
I thought they were going way north. Instead of just following the blue line. Well, I think I probably would have done. But this seems okay.
Yeah.
Any comfort to you, F1's taking the south route.
Oh, yeah, thanks for the info. That's interesting.
Or at least he's starting out that way.
Holy smokes, Gary. It's over 3.
Again?
It was like 3, a little over 3.
That was cool, huh?
This is a bust in here.
Yeah.
Jeez. Should have just cut the corner.
Yeah. It was a waste of time to turn up in there.
Yeah, totally. Thank you. They're doing pretty darn good over to the north. Richard's higher and further ahead now.
Really?
Yeah. You were behind me and probably about the same altitude. Now you're above me and in front.
That's the Arcus.
Of course, there's your superior flying skills to account for, too.
Well, yes.
I see what Tim's heading for.
Okay, what am I heading for?
That vertical wall there.
I'm just lost. Totally.
Looks like it could be a little bit tricky ahead there, John.
Yeah, it'd be nice. I should. There's that thermal back there.
Yeah.
I flew through it kind of a bit, but didn't turn. I think maybe I should have just stuck with it.
Yeah, I turned twice and then left it.
I'm going to slow way down a little bit for now, so I can be a little bit higher when I get to this merge.
Could go around the outside. It's a little detail. I see.
Well, I'm thinking this on at least on the exit, so this stuff looking really steep up there, so there will really be ridges at work, but the wind's not very strong, so this thing come from 4 meters per second.
No.
Jeez.
Don't say that.
It was just for a second, but it was on the nose. 4 meters per second. It's like I didn't even look at the right over here.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Gary.
I'm a little bit lost here.
Yeah, I think I took it the wrong way there. I was kind of screwed up. Bit of indecision.
Oh man, this is not going to be good. Without, of course, there's no thermals out here, so if someone gets out to this area, when there's a good, well-located thermal, we'll do really well, but...
Mike, show us the way.
I hope so. What I don't know is how I'm going to get over that big stuff in front of us.
Yeah, me neither. Do I hide? I already did, Mike.
Yeah, you're alive.
And you have an Atlas? And you have an Atlas?
I'm only at 1380.
Wow, the bridge here is terrible.
5 o'clock. Oh, wonderful.
Oh, I didn't even know. Yeah, that's a good point there.
Yep, the clouds are disappearing. get my map off south here, some little clues.
Sorry, Gary.
What happened, Gary?
Yeah, it's dark here. I didn't see the trees here.
Yeah, I think I'm going to have to make a complaint to these late starts. I mean, you don't start races at this time.
Wait, when was the last time they had a morning? I know they have done them, but a morning race would be more, you know, reasonable.
Is coming up. Move is high, coming from behind, but he's high. Oh, Josh, nice.
I feel a parking ticket.
Hoping to get some wave.
You can hope. There's plenty of wave chance. Get that very high.
This cloud looks like it's right on top of the bridge up there, the little Marine Valley. Valley.
Come on, cloud, you gotta give me something here.
One. Actually, I'm really enjoying this task because it's relatively mild conditions. You know, the wind's not really strong, the thermals aren't really strong. It's just kind of, it gets consistent at least.
That cloud gave me nothing.
Yeah, Richard, this is your ride, Matt.
Yep.
Yeah, those ridges working well, and that cloud is still, it's just sitting on top of that ridge, so it must be one of the ones that's, the thermal's attached to the slope.
on my way that way.
But either way, the ridge is good, so. There you go.
The ridge is positive. That slope to the south is really shallow. This is actually not as steep. Direction that wherever that thermal is going to be at so far up ahead. Well, so far I haven't gotten anything in that thermal, so I don't know if it may be too far to get, or it may be too high or something. But the ridge was still definitely worth going to.
Yeah.
So did you guys have a pass to get over going the way you went there when you said you thought you had a parking ticket, Mike? What was it at?
Ain't over it yet. I'm at 54.8.
54? Is that 5,400?
Oh, no. I'm at 1,700. The pass is at that location.
Oh. How much do you think you're going to need?
Hi, Josh.
Probably 19, 20.
Oh, boy.
Look good.
Yeah, your boss is me.
Hello. Hi there.
Yeah,
I'm just missing you.
I'm just trying to get higher. That thermal is right here. I think. Yeah, it's too high to think to get to recently, but I'm not gonna even try to do it anymore. Just that extra little bit of height should get me up high enough to go. Oh wait, no what? I think maybe it's right here in this little bowl. You might be a little bit too low, which you might want to go. It might be better to go a little further and come back. I don't know if it's actually going down. If you're getting lifted together, just
I got sort of 0.5, 0.6.
Yeah, this was hitting over 3, but it's very, very hard to use. I'm not going to wait any more time with it. The other people are catching up. Oh, geez. How fast is DGT? Wow. He's high and fast. That's nice.
The son from Riccardo Brigliadori, which is a real pilot that flies in England.
Okay.
Who was that? Were you talking about DGT?
The person just crashing.
Oh.
Na, kurz ein Zähler brauchen.
And 19 will get you over that.
Okay.
Trouble is, it leaves you dumped on a bad spot.
You talking about that just after the first turn point?
No. At the 54 to the turn point.
A bit different.
Yeah, it doesn't look too good.
Yeah, they probably should have made the last leg out in the flatlands evening task.
Yeah, at this time of day.
Yeah. I don't think a lot of us are going to make it.
I think Hoover had this, must have had a very specific idea. I bet you they wanted people to climb up in the wave so they can get final glide at the last turn point.
I didn't notice the time until I was well into this. That's the problem.
Yeah, I didn't either.
Knowing that, I would have been looking for altitude.
Time of today. 5 o'clock, I didn't realize. It's tea time.
Did you have power pyro in that tumble there, Richard?
Pretty high. Yeah, I did, yeah. I climbed up to the top of the ridge, a little bit over the top of the ridge.
Well, I'm really wishing I was higher now.
Okay, I can't see anyone in my area now. Wish you all a good flight. We're fine.
See you, Garrett.
Bye, Garrett.
Thanks,
Garrett.
Hey, Garrett,
ciao.
Have a good one.
I mean, I'm thinking I'm going to suffer through all this stuff and I'm going to get to the turn point and I'm never going to make it because all the clouds will be gone.
Yeah, I'm really wondering at this point. Yeah, I'm...
The ridge over to the north. You can get through that gap.
Yeah, well, I think this looks like it should be okay. There should be a little bit of lift in a second. But I just, once we get to the turn point, we gotta go over hills and everything. Oh, man.
Looks like DGT has played it well. And TZ?
Well, this is his task, right?
Is it? Okay.
Should be.
That explains it.
I think I did see that, yeah.
Well, he does this day. It's his day.
Yeah, I think this is the easy part.
Yeah. Yeah, at least one thermal back before. If we'd taken that one up into the cloud, it would have been a piece of cake.
Yeah, because DET's just cruising along on top of the ridge mountain up there. Yeah. Not losing any height, and now we're down here.
Scrabbling, yeah.
Enjoying the scenery.
Yeah, that's it. Counting the squirrels.
Also, Tango Zeta, Tango Zulu is very high,
yeah? Yep, yeah, both of them. And I think DB1 and PL7 are both pretty high as well.
I think that's a lesson in late tasks, is to get high and stay high.
Well, it doesn't help that somehow all the thermals have just been not where we've been going.
Yeah.
Yeah, but is DGT going to have enough for the last leg?
I don't know.
But let us gripe while we can. And be envious.
Which is pretty good.
What's happening there? I like this office.
Yeah, I enjoy flying it, yeah. Just get a handicap just a little bit. It looks, it's modeled nice, it looks nice, it flies nice. The cockpit's nice, it's got PD in the middle and the Arctic horizon.
I remember years ago we had a grog in the club. This kind of reminds me of that for some reason. Having space in the cockpit. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, my first flight in the Grove, I thought it was like sitting in a great big lazy boy type chair. Just so much space.
Yeah, it's a great.
We're talking about the twin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Astir or the Acro?
The Astir.
Okay. Yeah, I have to go to gym to fly that plane. It's really physical.
Yeah.
I mean, I fly the K-21 with two fingers, but the Grob I could fly with two hands.
But it's really comfortable.
520.
Thermal
when
it died.
Nice pull on the back.
Well, I'm at found life degree zero, so maybe this next leg won't be so bad as long as we can get around the mountains. Which we should be able to zigzag back to the line. The wind's not very good. I think this task is okay if he doesn't make it so late in the day. I think he's kind of over the line with it being so late in the day.
I don't know what's up with the task setters lately, but they've been, really making strange tasks. Ezekiel, you on here today?
Oh, yes.
PGT's done?
No. First turn point. he just turned to first turn point. Or the elbow turn point.
Now, even if you found a cloud, it's such a low cloud base.
Okay, I'm at 1730 at Tampa on turn point, and then I do have final glide 3.9. So as long as I don't, yeah, if I can zigzag along the ridges and maintain altitude, you will have found water in that below. It'll be a slow found water, but it'll be doable.
Hell, it's been a whole flight of slow
and low.
And low, yeah. Josh, pretty high.
You got lucky and climbed in a cloud way back.
I actually found one. I found one, but it only worked up to 15, and then it stopped.
Congrats, Richard.
Congrats, Richard.
Congrats, Richard.
I didn't know that. Oh, heck, and there's a password, Digiteers.
Congrats, John.
Congrats. Congrats, John.
Congrats.
So, Josh, when you were climbing out in that cloud, did you realize it was 5 o'clock?
Yeah, I knew.
Yeah, I can see how that would motivate you.
I was thinking those back hills would have a wave somewhere.
Man, this last leg is way too long, to be honest with
you. This is going to be a Halloween moment.
And he lived along there, too?
Nope.
Congrats, Tiso.
Thank you.
Congrats.
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 Congrats. And now?
Exactly.
Got some fairly good lift over here on this ridge. I'm just going to take it up till I've got final glide.
Sounds like a good plan.
Not going to be on the podium anyway, so I might as well.
GGT doesn't look like he's slowing down any.
No, he's got the height for it.
Well, I'm at 22 and I still don't have final glide at 2.3.
What's it look like over there, Tim?
Right here, it's pretty good at 2K.
Thomas?
Oh, it's about 2.5 on average.
That's pretty good. Making use of the cloud.
Hi, Tim.
Hi, Mike.
Yeah. This ridge face isn't bad. Congrats, easy.
Thanks, my friend.
Josh. Congrats. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Congrats.
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 bad.
Cloud worth flying into, Tim?
Let's see.
Oh, you're not there yet?
Nope. I got nothing.
Thank you. Congrats, Tim.
Congrats, Tim.
Congrats, Tim. That's right.
Thank you.
Congrats.
Congrats, Mike.
Way to go, Mike.
Thanks.
There is no minimum. Okay. I was not sure what the minimum was, and there's the name.
Is there any finishing time?
Nope, in the ground.
Congrats. You're
welcome. Congrats.
And we hit each other right there.
Nicely done, Bill.
Thanks. until DB1 finishes the discus and meet their one, maybe.
Yeah.
Curious to see how far up he goes. It's still fourth place. Good. Decatrude.
Yeah.
Rough for
scratch.
Yes.
So, good luck, everyone, and have a good day.
Well,
thanks.
Thank you.
Sir.
Okay, John. Have a good evening.
Again.
User
disconnected from your channel.
rocket boosters.
Congrats.
Congrats.
Yeah, congrats, Izzo.
Congrats.
Congrats. What is a fun finish? Have Ua, me, Ezekiel, Romeo, Mike, Tango. We're all within half a mile of one another.
P21 is going to make it.
Christos.
Congrats.
Christos.
Congrats, Josh.
Thank you.
Yeah, there was an out this day.
Not this Arcus.
Did be wanted very well.
Perfect. Yeah.
I was wondering what nobody answered my question. Richard, did you take an all north route at the beginning?
Yep, I did that. So,
and there was one thing we were wrong
there. Went north route at the beginning, we're better off.
Yeah. And there was one thermal along there, which if John and I had taken it up all the way, instead of just carrying on, that would have made it past easy.
Yeah, but definitely was Arcus there. I said when I choose Arcus, it's Duo Discus there. And when I choose Duo Discus, it's Arcus there. It's always the same.
Congrats, John.
Congrats.
It's called Murphy's Law. No, there's a book.
I take to the south, right? And then I cross to the north again. You know, when that gap that you cross, Mike, with 1,900 meters?
Yes.
Yeah.
Congrats, Bruce.
Thanks.
Congrats, Bruce.
Congrats, Bruce.
Yeah, I think it depends on the task, but this last task, Arcus is paying really good.
I must admit that the reason I chose Arcus this time is just because I like the cockpit.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Congrats, Mike.
Congrats, Mike.
Congrats, Mike. guys, anybody see the presentation of the GS5?
No.
No.
Was beautiful. Was on Instagram. And I think it's coming in Condor 3.
And congrats to you. Well done.
Congrats, Tim.
Congrats, Tim.
Congrats, Tim.
Congrats, Tim.
It calls JS5, Ray, Romeo, Echo, Yang.
What does the race stand for?
I don't know. The first flight, it was with a big thunderstorm. True story.
Did they film it then?
Yeah, I think it's on Instagram. Or Facebook too.
Wow, 2 hours of flying time to do 173 kilometers.
I think it's been didn't miss up.
That was a struggle, Mike. We went too far south.
Yeah, we did.
Well, guys, I have to go. Wish you all the best. Send you a big hug and maybe see you tomorrow. Take care.
Okay, yeah. Easy. Have a good evening.
Ezekiel, have a nice
we'll
day.
See you tomorrow.
Thank you, guys.
Bye-bye. Yeah, I'm in good shape.
User disconnected
from the
channel.
Around so long. I just wanted to finish. I've got like plus 150 at MC5 or so.
Yeah, that'll work.
That'll work.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's it's hard to get up that high, but once you get high enough where you got final glide, it sure is comfortable.
But I kind of like the task.
Yeah, except that it's a bit dark.
Yeah, because of all the cirrus.
I think
and the late time.
Early in the day, I would have appreciated it more.
That's 5 minutes after 6 Condor time.
Yeah, I'll say bye as well, and congrats all, and good luck to you, Bruce.
Thank you.
Okay, Tim, have a good evening, my friend.
You too.
Yeah, same from me. Dinner is waiting. So see you guys next time. Bye-bye.
See
okay,
you.
Enjoy
see
your Tim. Dinner. Bye-bye. See you, Richard.
My voice feels squeaky today after having that procedure done yesterday afternoon. Throat's kind of messed up.
Disconnected.